My name is Anders Fager. I'm a Swedish writer, and I'm right now in Epinal, and I'm very happy about being there. I've been writing professionally for 10 years. Before that, I worked with video games, and I was an army officer, so I've done a lot of different things. But right now, I'm the tentacle writer. These two books, Les Furies and Les Reins, are set in the same universe, the same modern Sweden, actually. So several characters appear now and again, and a very common reaction when people read this is when they get to the end, they feel like, oh, now I understand the whole thing and I have to read it again. The ideas of building, working in the same universe, I think it came from reading Neil Gaiman's Sandman, which is sort of a big mythology. And I would love to say that I had planned everything from the start, but a lot of things came along the way, and after a while I learned how to sort of tie them together to appear very clever. There are actually three more novels in the same universe, and had I known from the start that I would write 1,000 pages of this stuff, I would certainly have made timelines and ID cards for characters and stuff, just to keep track of them. Now I spent a lot of time researching myself. Myvit started out actually from the idea, there was a gallery next to where I lived, and there must be something strange going on there. So the story started from that kind of, you know, what if. And then Me came out of, she's sort of a parody of these very, you know, very physical, very experimental artists like Mariana Abramovic or people like that. Some of my characters, when it's their turn, they sort of show up for work and give me my lines, and they do their lines, and then they walk away. The Furies, for instance, the teen girls. But me, she moves into my apartment and starts moving furniture and sort of, oh, this is an installation. I just made your refrigerator into art and stuff like that. I think both those novels, short stories, are one of the ones that I've cut down the most, because she's constantly, she's like an extension of me, obviously, which also is so full of ideas. The part with her in the hospital is very inspired from a friend of mine who sat in isolation because of a drug thing. And they were not too allowed to read any papers, talk to anyone but their lawyer, and in this small room, they're waiting for the trial. And she just described how the room got smaller and smaller, and how things sort of got Salvador Dali on her. Is the social aspect important to me? No, it's the way to draw you into the madness, because those are the things you understand and think, oh, this is pretty normal. The story about the festivals. We have all been at one of these retirement places, and they smell horrible, and there are sort of dead people walking around. So we all know the place. That's sort of the trick. One of the tricks with these stories are that you are actually with the monsters. There are no heroes here, and there are no sort of good people figuring out what is happening. There's no family like in Stephen King who has, there's a monster in the basement or something. These stories are about the monsters in the basement. The monsters are the heroes. I am from Sweden, and Sweden is terribly well organized, very clean, everything works, it's very Protestant, it's very orderly, and I grew up in that, hoping for something to be strange or weird, in those days we had one TV channel and everything was very orderly and bum 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 bum. So this is what I dreamt of all my life, bad things or strange things or magic. This universe will be these books, three novels, and eventually a final collection of short stories. I more or less know which stories I want to tell. And by that time, we have done a comic book, a game, and seven books. And I think I'll be done by then. I will do something else. I'm writing a children's book right now, and I also wrote a very gothic novel that is the antithesis to this. That will be out in English this fall, that book. It's called For the Love of Goddess.